هيا على الفلاح.
Assalamu alaikum, my brothers and sisters. Some of you are asking me for my opinion on following the Imam online, on the television, or on the internet, or a device such as a receiver, the radio, etc. in Salah. I want to let you know that there are several opinions in this regard. The majority of ulama across the globe have still said that it is best not to follow the Imams through the television or through the internet or through the radio and so on. And there is another opinion, and we respect all opinions, but the reason why I am also one of those who holds the opinion that if you cannot make salah with jama'ah in the masjid, then do your salah with jama'ah in the home. And if you cannot do the salah with jama'ah in your home because you don't have the number or you don't have anyone to do it with, then read it alone in the home. So these are the different categories shown to us by the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Now, if you look at, for example, following a television, number one, there is a delay. Sometimes the delay can be up to 20 seconds, depending on where you're living, how fast the speed is, and many other factors, even the weather, and depending on what device or apparatus you're listening to. So the Imam would already have finished his, for example, ruku', and you are still busy standing because you can still hear him reading the surah, for example. So there is a delay. Sometimes the delay is smaller, sometimes it's a very short delay, but still, the sufuf, or the lines that are meant to be filled, are not being filled. One might argue that, okay, maybe we might want to waive that. I believe that you only waive it when it's absolutely necessary and you are the musallis of that particular masjid. You know, when you go to al Masjid al-Haram in Makkah al-Mukarramah, and they leave a few gaps, and some of them are reading a bit further back, sometimes even within a building at the times of Hajj and so on. Because of that being massive, you're still following the same masjid right in front of you, and it is there in front of you, and you are not in front of the Imam in terms of Qibla, and you're following him, and it is there. You know, it's not another masjid somewhere else, and you are at the masjid, it's just that there is a large number, and that's the reason. So if you are going to follow it from a distance, I've already given you two things. Number one is a delay. Number two is the issue of the sufuf. Number three is something interesting. Do you know where the Qibla is? So the Imam has to always be Amam. Al-Imamu Amam. The Imam is in the front. The Imam has to stand in the front, right? So when you are following him from somewhere in your suburb or somewhere in another city, and I was asked this by people who were following an Imam in a totally different city. The problem is that Imam, you may be 1,000 kilometers in front of them, and the Qibla is further away from him, so that your Imam is behind you 1,000 kilometers. I mean, what salah is that? Which hadith of the Prophet ﷺ would allow you to have an Imam 1,000 km behind you? You know, so rather than that, and like I say, this is a discussion that is open. This is my opinion, and I'm not belittling other opinions, but I'm letting you know why I'm saying, if you cannot do it one way according to the sunnah, do it another way according to the same sunnah, and do it a third way according to the same sunnah. Like when the Prophet ﷺ says, if you cannot fulfill your salah standing, you can do so sitting. If you cannot do it sitting, then do so lying down. So when he said that, some people are thinking that, well, if I cannot do my salah standing because my legs are paining, why don't I just hang on the ceiling and do it so my legs don't pain? Well, I tell you what, hanging may be a solution in your mind, but it's not one of the three things suggested in the hadith. So best you stay away. If you cannot stand, just sit, don't hang. So what I'm saying, if you cannot join the jama'ah in the masjid, do your jama'ah outside of the masjid, somewhere else, inshallah. Don't hang. Do you get what I mean? Another reason is sometimes there is an interruption. The interruption means, you know, you might have good internet, you might have good television connection, whatever else, because of weather, because of any other reason. We spoke about delay, but this is not delay. This is an interruption. You could have, for example, something that you didn't hear. How many times when I am speaking to you, for example, you cannot hear one or two words of mine because they're cut. Cut by what? Muffled by the internet, or because of the interruption in internet, it is cut. So that interruption, the Imam said, Sami Allahu liman hamida. You didn't hear it. And suddenly you just hear Allahu Akbar. What to do? I don't know. It's radio. I'm confused. You spoilt your whole salah. It's going to happen everywhere. The first world countries might think, well, it won't happen with us. It will, and it can, and it does, and it has. And with us in the third world, whoa, 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 it's so difficult to even have a live show simply because words are eaten and it's interrupted. And how irritating is that? Imagine when you're listening to Taraweeh and you hear غير الضالين. What did you hear? The maghdubi alayhim was eaten. I'd rather have someone in front of me fulfilling the salah in a proper way than to follow someone far off, and I've got so many things that are possibly wrong with that. Subhanallah. So that is a total interruption. In our countries, we have what's known as a power cut. So suddenly, if you were allowed to follow someone far, far off, you suddenly have a power cut. What happens? You don't know. Confusion, salah, then you're gonna have to resort anyway to that salah with jama'ah in your home. So these are some of the reasons. And like I say, we in the ummah have been taught certain things. I've only told you what has just come to my mind. So I prefer my brothers and sisters benefit from the online lectures, benefit from online recitations. You should listen to the prayers, how we listen to Makkah and Medina all the time and so on. But I would advise you not to follow online a masjid that is, you know, a far off masjid, etc., for many, many reasons. Sometimes, like I said, another reason comes to my mind right now. It's not even in the right time zone sometimes, where people in New York are following someone from San Francisco, for example. Come on, their salah hasn't even entered the time. And look what's happening. They're already following the imam. So there is a lot that would actually go wrong. And the last point I want to raise is the day that we are no longer going to have this issue, and inshallah that's very soon, I hope, people will become so used to doing this online prayer that they will just turn on the TV, turn and say, hey guys, I don't need to go anymore. And you know, I'm just, wow, wow, this was so good, so convenient. And then what will happen? Then the masjids will really be empty for no reason. At the moment, there is a reason. What the reason is coronavirus and so on. But may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala safeguard us. I just want to reiterate and repeat, I'm not a person to shoot down opinions or people who hold other opinions. They are my brothers. I love them with the full love that I'm supposed to be giving them and beyond. But at the same time, it's just my humble opinion not to join the prayers. You benefit from everything. I will listen to the Quran and the lectures and whatever. But my prayers, I will do in my own jama'ah at home if I cannot go to the masjid. And the day I can, I will race to the masjid and be there, inshallah, before time to make up for lost time. I hope these few words have benefited you in preparation for the month of Ramadan. Like I said, it is an opinion. There are some scholars who do hold the opinion of permissibility, even those, they have many conditions. So be careful to just turn on the TV and start following, because even those who say it's permissible, they've got a lot of conditions. Find out some of those conditions are so difficult to tick off. Be careful. Jazakumullah khair. May Allah forgive us all. Wallahu a'lam. Wa sallallahu wa sallam wa baraka ala nabina Muhammad. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Thank you so much for listening to this short message. I pray that it has increased you in a little bit of motivation and hope. And the same applies to all of us. Jazakumullah khair. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.